Hello everyone, my name is Christelle Gambula and I am Solution Architect at Amazon Ads. In this video, I will walk you through the process to call Amazon Ads Conversion API. But first, let's go through the prerequisites together. To get started with Conversion API, you need to get your login with Amazon credentials. These credentials are the API credentials you use to generate an access token. If you don't have API credentials, I invite you to watch the video walkthrough I did in the description of this video, which goes through the steps to create your API credentials. The second and third prerequisites are to obtain IDs that you will pass in your API calls. The first is to retrieve a profile which corresponds to an Amazon DSP entity, from which you can obtain an advertiser ID to link your conversions to a given Amazon DSP advertiser account. And the last step, or the last prerequisite, is to get familiar with Amazon Ads Advanced Tool Centers, where you can find the conversion API documentation and all other Amazon Ads API docs. Now, let's dive into the conversion API use cases. At high level, Conversion API is a server-to-server API which allows advertisers to share of Amazon conversion signals, regardless of if they occur online or offline. There are three use cases, not limited to, that I wanted to share with you today. The first is if the advertiser wants to associate offline conversion with Amazon DSP campaigns. The second use case is if an advertiser wants to deduplicate conversion signals across multiple feeds. For example, if you are sending the hashed email by an online and offline field, you will be able to let us know which one you count and in which campaign. And the last one is if the advertiser is not able to use Amazon ad tag. In that case, we do want to make this API as an alternative to send signals dynamically through the website. And now, let's look at the different steps to enable Conversion API. The first step is to create a conversion definition using the conversion definition endpoint. By calling this endpoint, it will create the shell of your conversion feed. You can use the same endpoint to update your conversion definitions by including the conversion definition ID in the payload. And here are a list of required inputs, such as the name, the source type, the source, conversion type, etc. The second step, as needed, offers you the conversion definition list endpoints to retrieve all available conversion definitions created and associated with an advertiser. You can also filter the results by conversion definition ID. And the last step is to import your conversion events. And so once you have created your conversion definition and you have your conversion definition ID, you can start to import events in real time or in batch requests to the conversion definition event data endpoint. The event data endpoint will use the match key field added in the payload for identity resolution. And so this is a required field or among the required fields in which you will pass hashed PII information, such as the hashed email or the phone. And now let's move to Postman, a popular development tool. Postman simplified testing, making it an excellent choice for this demo. However, there are other tools you can leverage for API integration, and Postman is not a prerequisite. As you can see in Postman, I have preset the operations and endpoints that I will be testing today. Starting with the get profile endpoint, which I will use to retrieve the Amazon Ads account IDs that I will need to make subsequent API calls. And the ID that I am interested in is the profile ID, which corresponds to an Amazon DSP entity. And now let's go to the authorization tab. In here, I have preset a couple of fields, such as the access token, which is a variable in my Amazon Ads environment, the prefix, as well as the new token configuration that I have preset prior to this demo. If you are curious to know about those fields and how to set it up, again, feel free to check the onboarding video in the description. Moving to header, and here there are two keys that I will need to call the profile endpoint. The first is the Amazon Advertising API client ID, which corresponds to your client ID that you have created in your login with Amazon application or your developer portal. The second key is the content type, and here I have set it up to application JSON. Checking quickly that nothing is in the body, and I will just click send. In here, I have a 200 response code, which confirms that I've made a successful API call. And what I'm going to do now is to search for my DSP demo account, Amazon DSP demo account, as you can see here, demo US. And from that profile or in the response, I am able to get the profile ID, the ID that I would need to make the other calls in the list. I will now move to get advertisers. In the get advertisers endpoint, I'm also checking in the header the different keys that I will need to make this API call. And the client ID is the same one that I've added in the previous call, the content type as well. And here there's a new key, which is the Amazon Advertising API scope. This one corresponds to the profile ID that I have retrieved in the previous API call. And so I have set it up as a variable in my environment, and I am adding it here. Checking as well, nothing in the body, and clicking send. And here as well, I have a 200 response code, which confirms the success of my API call. And what I will do is to search for a test advertiser account that I will use for this demo. Here it is. And from that response, I also get the advertiser ID that I will need to create my conversion definition, but as well to retrieve conversion definitions and import conversion events. I have set it up as a variable in my environment. Moving now to create definition. And so here I'm just moving to the header. So the authorization is also leveraging the same access token. And some of the fields we have previously used are preset as well, such as the client ID and the scope. However, I have left the content type blank because this information is specific per endpoint. And so I have checked the API documentation and retrieved the required value here. I am copying it and pasting it here. Another information that I need to update here is in the URL. And so here you can see account ID. And in fact, the account ID corresponds to the advertiser ID that we have retrieved in the previous API call. As it is set as a variable, I will just retrieve it and set it here. In the body, I need to pass the required field to create the conversion definition. And so again, I have leveraged the example from the documentation and pasted it here. And so a couple of fields need to be updated here, starting with the counting method, which means that you are setting the method used to determine whether all or only the first conversion event per user per conversion definition are ingested within 24 hours window. I will let it as every. The other fields, such as the source type, are available in the online documentations where you can see all the enums. And in my case, I will just leave it to offline. And so this corresponds to offline event. The name, I will just update it to sample test. So here as well, you have the enums available in the online documentation. And for this demo, I will use this server to server as I just want to send offline conversion straight to Amazon DSP. And the conversion tab is add to shopping cart, which I am happy with. You can see that there is the value as well, and I have set it up to 0. But if you would have your conversion type linked to purchases, you would indicate here the value of the purchase. The payload seems right, and so I will click send. And here I have a 207 response code, which confirms that I have made a successful API call. And as well, under this success array, I am able to retrieve the conversion definition ID, which I will need to make following API call. So I'm saving it. And move to retrieve conversion definition. And so in here, it's also a post call, but the list endpoint. And similar to previous calls, I will leverage the client ID, the profile ID corresponding to the scope, and add the right content type that I have retrieved from the API doc. Moving to the body. And here I've also leveraged the example from the documentation. And in my case, I just want to retrieve all the conversion definitions that I've created. And click send. As you can see here, we have a 200 response code, which means that I have all the conversion definition created under that same advertiser ID. The last one created is this one. And so I will save the conversion definition ID again for the next API call. Moving now to the last step, import conversion API call. Here as well, I'm in the header page and I'm going to paste the right content type. Moving now to the body, and similar to previous call, I will just leverage the example from the online documentation. And so with the name, I will just call it event, the conversion definition ID. I will take the one created previously and paste it here. The match keys. In here, I can pass the hashed email that is associated with that event. And the only hash that we are supporting today is the SHA256. And so I previously hashed my conversion email and I'm pasting it here. The value, I will let it to zero. The source is still service to server. And so it looks right. And I will send that event to the conversion ID specified here, which is associated to the same advertiser. Clicking send. Now I have a 207 response code, which again corresponds to a successful API call. And I can see as well here the index of my conversion event that I have been sent successfully. Now, let's see how it looks like in the user interface. I will log into my Amazon Ads console. My password. And click sign in. In here, I am in my demo US account. And so I will go to advertisers. In here, I will search for the test advertiser that I used for the purpose of this demo, which is sample test advertiser here. And I will then go to event managers and click the conversion tab. In here, I can see all the conversions definitions that I've created, as well as the last activity and the last updated. And that's it for the user interface. Before we wrap up, I wanted to flag a few common errors. The first one is when you make your API call, you may get a 4SX error, which requests you to accept the terms and condition. If you retrieve or if you get such error message, I advise you to just log in using the URL based in the response to accept the terms and condition directly in the console. And that's it. Thank you, and I wish you happy advertising. Bye.